Today we're going to be casting a handwheel for my arbor press in the side shop there. We're going to make some play sand I bought at the local hardware store with some sodium silicate. Roughly about a cup. Later on you're going to see it's a pretty rough casting and I should have used a little bit finer mesh of sand. I'm going to gently place it in here and then I'm going to pack it down lightly. Now I was caught a little bit unprepared today, so I came a little bit short with the sand. So I'm going to have to add a board in behind here, but that's no big deal. Now a really cool chemical reaction happens when you push CO2 through sodium silicate. It acts somewhat like a binder that you'd see in resin. It will hold together quite well while you're pouring your mold, and then break down easily once you're done. Once you push CO2 once again, you'll have to double check to make sure you didn't miss any spots, and then also when you flip it over, you're going to have to check the other side as well and touch up as necessary. In a previous video, I had a detailed explanation on how I made this split pattern, so feel free to check it out, and don't forget to subscribe if you like this video. Once again, I'm mixing about one bag to about a cup of sodium silicate. The drill I'm using is a larger size drill with a paint mixer or a grout mixer on the end of it. A considerable amount of effort should be put in to make sure that it's mixed thoroughly or you're going to have issues. Special attention has to be paid to where the wheel's actually going to be, because later I'm going to have to put in vents. Now a few errors were made with venting, but in the end I did get a decent casting. Entirely by accident I forgot to put parting powder between the two molds, but it seemed to turn out just fine. Perhaps here is where I made one of my errors in the venting. Later on you'll see where some shrinkage happened on the casting of the handwheel. After letting it sit for about 15-20 minutes to cool off and solidify, I broke it out from its mold. Perhaps not one of the smartest things I can do to spray water on it, however the kids sure did enjoy it. Special thanks to the Facebook community, Backyard Metal Casting and Foundry Work. After asking some questions, the group helped me point out that I had the wrong mesh of sand, the riser was too short, and perhaps the vents were not needed or in the wrong place. However, for what I'm going to use it for today, this will work just fine, but the next one I'm going to have to work harder on. It would have been nice to have a higher riser on it so I could grab it in the lathe. However, I figured it out in the mill machine, luckily. Then I'm going to use a dial to find center on it. That way, as it spins through my hand on the machine, it'll feel correct and on center. Then I'll center drill it. Drill with a drill slightly smaller than the finished dimension, and then I'll ream it size. Remember, when you're power reaming, you want to go twice the feed and half the speed, and lots of oil. My best friend Bondo. This will help me undo all of the errors that I had. Since it's non-structural, it's just going to be a cosmetic fix. And a bit of time. This rasp file worked quite well for knocking off the parting lines. Now for another learning moment. Pay special attention to the angle of the tap. I didn't leave enough material once again sticking out from the side, so it had to go in at a bit of an angle. In the end, it'll still work just fine. However, next time I'm going to do a little bit better at it. Now this next operation, I'm going to broach the keyway in here. In essence, it's just a precision saw that's going to cut the keyway on the inside of the aluminum material. I find it quite ironic that this machine is making itself. Special attention has to be paid to make sure the broach is perpendicular to the work and never bent at an angle. These are glass-hard tools, and they'll bust without warning, costing you a fresh $100 to $200, depending on the quality you buy. Simple as that. Hey, don't forget to hit subscribe or like. I'd really appreciate it. It helps me out. And stay tuned for the next video.